Well, we want to welcome everyone this morning. We do have a full day today of fun things happening. We have a quarterly meeting, and we have a lunch together. We're dish to pass. Lunch has been prepared. So we're starting a little earlier so that we can still fit in everything else and follows the quarterly meeting afterwards. So as far as announcements go, we have prayer every Sunday at 9:30. Is that my battery? It's not still on. English Sunday worship is going to be back. It looks like the bulletin is incorrect. Back at 10:30 next week. So I got it on the slide, but I didn't get it in the bulletin. So bulletin's incorrect. Youth group is at 6 p.m. on Fridays. And quarterly meeting is today. And we have a baptism coming on the 1st of August. So lots of good things coming. The big agenda for the business meeting today is we want to formally request the calling of Samuel as pastor for the congregation. And so that will be a big step forward for us. And Brian's going to come and pray for us. And I've been talking with Ginger quite a bit the last couple of days, and she says Billy's doing a little better than when he went into the hospital. He's on medications. So Brian will give you the rest of the information on that as well. But we're looking and praying for Billy this morning that he'll be recovering and coming home.
Well, good morning. Yeah, and Ginger's online with us this morning, too, so it's another blessing of our technology. Ginger, you ready for an update in person here?
Absolutely. So they have Billy in the...
Okay, let's bow our hearts in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day and thank you for this time that we have to get together and to, and praise your name, Lord. And we just thank you for all the other things that are going on during the week. The youth ministries, the counseling sessions, the singing nights, all the ways that your name is praised, Lord, and your body is getting together to worship you and to lift you up, Lord. And we just thank you for all the activities we do. Just thank you for bringing Samuel here to Mattawa, Lord. And we just pray that you would continue to open doors for us and him to continue to go through to spread your word here. And Lord, we just thank you for the lives that are being changed, Lord. And that the evidence of that, Lord. We also are thankful for the youth, Lord, and just we pray that they would continue to read the books in the Old Testament they've been assigned and do the work it takes to memorize the order of the Old Testaments that we're having them do to get ready. We're also thankful for the willingness of the youth in Portland to come to Mattawa to interact with our kids, to and do some Bible drills and all that, Lord. We just thank you, and we just pray for those plans that we're making. Those plans that you're making that we're following. Lord, we just pray for Doug Merkel's grandson, Lord, to just pray for that he would recover, Lord, and just surround him. And you know all the details, Lord. We don't need to know the details, but Lord, that he's hurting after this accident, and Lord, we just pray for a recovery of his body, Lord, and and his health as he's very young. And Lord, we also just pray for his relationship and his spirit with you. And Lord, we just continue to pray for Jenny and healing in this process, Lord. And we just thank you that she's been able to get back home. And Lord, that's just an answer to prayer that she's been able to recover so quickly from the hip surgery and then the fall, Lord. And we just pray that she would just be able to lean on you and enjoy life without having all the hallucinations and difficulties and things that make life so hard for her, Lord. We just pray that she'd be able to focus on you and enjoy the days she has with her family and all the events that are going on and all the wonderful things that are happening in the Hedman family. Lord, we just lift up the rest of the service for you, and we just give it all to you. And these things we lift up in Jesus' name. Amen.
Our call to worship this morning is from Psalm 25, verses 1 to 6. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O my God, in you I trust. Let me not be put to shame. Let not my enemies exult over me. Indeed, none who wait for you shall be put to shame. They shall be ashamed who are wantonly treacherous. Make me to know your ways, O Lord. Teach me your paths. Lead me in the truth and teach me. For you are the God of my salvation. For you I wait all day long. Remember your mercy, O Lord, and your steadfast love, for they have been from of old.
All right, well, stand with me and we're going to sing. Are you ready, Debbie? All right. Nope. Back, Brian. Okay. Our first song is In Christ Alone. And the scripture that we're going to read is Ephesians 2, 19 through 22. So then, you are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Christ Jesus himself being the cornerstone, in whom the whole structure, being joined together, grows into a holy temple in the Lord. In him, you also are being pulled together into a dwelling place for the God by the Spirit. Alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace. When fears are stilled, when striving cease, my comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the ground he rose again. And as he stands in victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Now he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. So a little thanks to Samuel there, because he just had me sing that song over and over again, because he loves it and he loves hearing it. So I've been singing this every Tuesday night, and now even some of the Spanish speakers that only speak Spanish are starting to sing that with me. My faith has found a resting place, Romans 10:17. So faith comes from hearing, and hearing through the word of Christ. Found a resting place, not in device nor creed. I trust the ever-living one, his wounds for me shall plead. I need no other argument, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died, and that he died for me. Enough for me that Jesus saves, this ends my fear and doubt. A sinful soul, I come to him, he'll never cast me out. I need no other argument, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died, and that he died for me. My heart is leaning on the word, the living word of God. Savior's name, salvation through his blood. I need no other argument, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died, and that he died for me. My great physician heals the sick, the lost he came to save. For me his precious blood he shed, for me his life he gave. I need no other argument, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died, and that he died for me. I need no other argument, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died, and that he died for me. So we are always of good courage. We know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. By faith we see the hand of God in the light of creation's grand design, in the lives of those who prove his faithfulness, who walk by faith and not by sight. By faith our fathers roamed the earth with the power of his promise in their hearts, of a holy city built by God's own hand, a place where peace and justice reign. We'll stand as children of the promise. We will fix our eyes on him, our soul's reward, till the race is finished and the work is done. We'll walk by faith and not by sight. By faith the prophets saw a day when the longed for Messiah would appear, with the power to break the chains of sin and death, and rise triumphant from the grave. By faith the church was called to go in the power of the Spirit to the lost, to deliver captives and to preach good news in every corner of the earth. We will stand as children of the promise, and we will fix our eyes on him, our souls reward, till the race is finished and the work is done. We'll walk by faith and not by sight. By faith this mountain shall be moved, And the power of the gospel shall prevail. For we know in Christ all things are possible. For all who call upon his name, we will stand as children of the promise. And we will fix our eyes on him, our soul's reward, till the race is finished and the work is done. We'll walk by faith and not by sight. We will stand as children of the promise. And we will fix our eyes on him, our soul's reward, till the race is finished and the work is done. We'll walk by faith and not by sight. We'll walk by faith and not by sight. That was fun. Next, speak, O Lord, 1 Thessalonians 2:13. And we also thank God continuously for this, that when you received the word of God, which you heard from us, you accepted it not as the word of men, but what it really is, the word of God, which is at work in you believers. It's at work in us.
O Lord, as we come to you to receive the food of your holy word, take your truth, plant it deep in us, shape and fashion us in your likeness, that the light of Christ might be seen today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, and fulfill in us all your purposes for your glory. Teach us, Lord, full obedience, holy reverence, true humility. Test our thoughts and our attitudes in the radiance of your purity. Cause our faith to rise, cause our eyes to see your majestic love and authority. Words of power that can never fail, let their truth prevail over unbelief. Speak, O Lord, and renew our minds. Help us grasp the heights of your plans for us. Truths unchanged from the dawn of time that will echo down through eternity. And by grace we'll stand on your promises, and by faith we'll walk as you walk with us. Speak, O Lord, till your church church is built, and the earth is filled with your glory. Speak, O Lord, till your church is built, and the earth is filled with your glory.
Yeah, this is one of those songs that's a little bit of a residual of a Joel singing with us. Galatians 2:20. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. Ancient words. This is Jim's new song for me this week, the one I had to learn. Hebrews 1:1-2. Long ago, at many times and in many ways, God spoke to our fathers by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son, whom he appointed the heir of all things, through whom also he created the world.
Changing me and changing you, we have come.
Benediction is from the same passage from as we read last week. It's Hebrews 13, 20 and 21. Now may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, equip you with everything good that you may do his will, working in us what is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.